Hi, Cancer Leo Cubs. How y'all doing today? It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, darling. What say you, honey? So let's get cracking. Let's just get straight on into the shit. Okay. But how y'all been doing? How y'all been doing? Oh, I don't write to the music and all of that shit. Petty and true. What is it my Cancer Leo Cups need to keep it real about? What is it they need to know? What is it they need to get through their head, spirit? Like, what do we need to get through our head? What we just not paying attention to? I gotta know. I just gotta know, y'all. Now I'm bringing questions. I'm trying to get through my own head to y'all. I don't know. Somebody out there want to know the same damn thing. Like, what is it I'm not seeing here in ancestors? Have Cancer Leo Cups see what they not seeing. Like, beat it up. They beat it upside their head. This that Mary I used to love, bitch. What's the energy for my Cancer Leo Cups here in ancestors? Worthiness. Okay, that's your energy. Alchemy. Ooh, Nefertiti titty. Worthiness. Yeah, so somebody know they worth. They know what they bring to the table. They know what cup to fill with what around this bitch, period. Okay. Come on now. What the hell are some little big things? Look, these merry-go-rounds. Like, you're not about to play with me. I will play with you. Okay, look at that green grass growing all around. Look how she like, ugh, you stink. Y'all know I got a problem with the stench. Look at her face. Like, ugh, bitch, you stink. Who is this hoe? Like, ew, I need a wet nap. Ew. You know, what did Nikki say? Ew. Number 14, worthiness. That just took a stroke through my veins. Like, I don't have time for this foolishness. I could be studying something, learning something, putting a potion together, having tea. You know, talking about some real stuff. But you know what? Why are there, like, lights on this side and this dark on this side? Maybe those are two different. This is like magic. What kind of flowers is these? Is these the lilies? This is like magic. Look at all of the little pixie stuff behind her. And that's so funny. That's my nail color. Pixie. Look at all of this behind her. Oh, bitch, you done leveled the fuck up. If this your energy, I'm scared of you. I don't know if I want another one or not. Oh, hand energy, y'all. Come on, scratch with me. Come on, scratch. Everybody get some of this juiciness. What else is the energy for my Cancer Leo cup? Oh, shit. Our favorite card, surrender. And the goddamn umbilical cord. Cut the cord. You know your worth now, and that's probably what you're doing. You're cutting the cord with something or someone or whatever. It could be a habit that you finally releasing. Whatever the hell it is. It could be like just straight up in your head. Get this shit out of your fucking head and allow yourself to be treated worthy enough. Hell, I don't know what else to say. Because it's like, you need to allow someone to fill you up. Allow somebody to match what you bring to the table. Don't instantly crucify people. And it won't stop. Boom. I'm using the muse, y'all. The muse. This is my little Mother's Day gift to my damn self. How about that? The muse. So, hidden ancestors, tell us about this worthiness for my Cancer Leo Cups. Tell us about this worthiness. What my Cancer Leo Cups need to surrender to. What's the cord that need to be cut? Or what's the connection? It's like the mom and her kids. It don't say cut the umbilical cord. It's just saying it's a umbilical cord. It's like teach them everything you know. They have a light to them too. You know, they have your DNA. Your children have your DNA. Teach them what you know. Allow them to come towards you. Because I had did that with my children. I had just wound up saying, like, I'm going to let them believe whatever they want to believe at a certain point. I feel like I was trying to push what I believed on them. So, my son had his own way of thinking. And I'm like, okay. At least I knew his way of thinking. It's another thing when y'all know somebody's spiritual or religious way of thinking. Or how they feel about the other rams and stuff like that. Okay. Tell us about Cancer, you know, close to your ancestors. Come on now you want to mess up on the last, huh? I got to do it one more time. It ain't going to be right. Spirit, it's not going to be right. I want my dick. Okay, let's get into this. Page of Emotions. Page of Cups. Page of Emotions. Ooh, look at that motherfucker. This is an octopus. These fishes is going to your heart. These fish could be money. Money made me come. Or this is just like the ways to your heart. You're healing it. The fishes could be coming to heal different parts of your heart. And remember I kept on saying somebody's stomach is hurting. My stomach is hurting. You see how this is in her stomach? It's a roll. It's a pathway in her stomach. That's what's going on here. Somebody feels something in their stomach. You probably need to release whatever pain you got bubbling in your stomach. You know that grain of rice of somebody on your mind, that grain of rice of any type of possibility about something. Oh, Lord. Y'all. Not the cats. I can't do the cats today. All right up under that is the sun and the three of inspirations. This is in a fool. Come on now. Knight of materials. Anyway, tell us about worthiness for my Cancer, Leo, Cubs, Spirit, and Ancestors. Why is worthiness here? Two of materials. Oh, you busy. You the busy, busy duck. You got a lot going on, honey. You busy. Six of emotion. Oh, my God. You got happy thoughts about the past now. You thinking about the for the good times. And justice, I don't know. However you say it came out. I'm going to say reverse right now because of an injustice. You could have had a past injustice that's causing this busy act. We're going to clarify. You're not, bitch. You're not mine. Hey, yeah, this is a past injustice, baby. This about to lead up to your justice. Shut the fuck up, bitch. Okay. Tell us more about this worthiness, Spirit. I'm not going to do a roll for each card. Come on, Spirit. Tell me more about this worthiness for my Cancer Leo Cubs. What is this shit? Two of inspirations. That's like two of swords. So fine. You got my mind. Come on, bitches. She's not fine. She's not fine. Not emotions. Tell me more about this worthiness, okay? Somebody possibly made you try to make you feel unworthy. It's a ten of wheels. Ooh, baby. Is that money? What the fuck is a ten of wheels? What up? Look at that shit right there. Let's get this on out here. Then we can figure it out. One more card for worthiness, Spirit, and Ancestors for my Cancer Leo Cups. They gave us two. Okay, Spirit, we gonna do what we can do. It's the Knight of Voices and Seven of Materials. What you keep whining about, child? Listen, these cats is acting crazy. It looked like some, something, it's like what I had said. Somebody possibly had you with some type of competition. Or it was some competition surrounding something. That's when you found your worthiness. Some injustice happened to you within this injustice. You found some type of worthiness. It probably had you in your head a whole lot about this. I don't know what the Ten of Wheels is. Let me find the Ten of Wheels. But this two inspiration, two of swords, something had you in your head a whole lot about this situation. But this is what I want you to understand. As peachy clean as you think you might be. Bitch, I'm about to tell you something. You got karma too. Okay? And I don't know, you better go think about it. Because even though this is an injustice against you, it could be an injustice against you because of something you did against someone else. And it could have been petty. You could have did some petty ass bullshit and it came back to you 10 times worse. The only good thing about this is because you have grown since then, you made a negative to a positive. You know, the lemonade story. You took the lemonades and made lemonade out of it. You took the dog on, you set fire to the fucking rain. That's what you did. Ooh, bitch, you got messy with this situation. You done healed a lot of your past. You done healed that past injustice. That's what caused you to move on. You done healed that little girl. You done healed that chick that you played and lied to. Look, you see her over here sitting down? The younger you. Some people probably have like a Barry, you gotta find another word. I'm not about to say that right now. And you can get mad at me, but you gotta find another word. I say you done had some type of sexual misconduct happen to you. Because this is the deep-rooted motherfucking truth here. This is deep-rooted all the way down to your childhood. Listen, when you were so innocent and pure and didn't know no better, it's something about that time that you need to heal from. Somebody left you, whatever. You was waiting on somebody that never came back. You could still be waiting on somebody that never came back. Shed so many tears. And this karmic cycle had to come back and finish out. This probably was the last bit of yourself that you needed to heal from the past. And I'm not saying something else might not arise. But I'm talking about for this journey, for this level up, you needed to heal this particular part of your past. And it could be some type of sexual injustice that happened to you or some fear around sex. That's what I'm getting here. You got to deal with this fear around sex or what people probably called you or anything. Just any insecurity of your body that people used to attack in your youth. It could be something the teacher said, a way the teacher touched you. It can go as far as that, a sibling touching you, whatever the hell the case may be. You needed to go within and you needed to heal that before you moved on to this next stage. And you had to make that decision on your own. Nobody else is here to help you make this decision. This is your new this is your blueprint. It's time to start drawing how you about to go from here. Either you going to let that injustice take you down or is you going to decide to trust spirit, trust that it was a cause for all of this, trust that maybe you need to teach other girls and even young men. Oh, I'm supposed to be looking up this Ten of Wheels. Oh, no, this is the will. There you go. A karmic injustice. Karmic justice. You know what, spirit. You know what. You just had to take me through that. Some type of truth have came in. And it came in flying from the ancient ones, baby. It came up out of the fucking water. Shining light on what the fuck the truth was. The spirit is basically telling you, you've been planting good oats since then, you know? You have been doing your entire best and you've been helping it grow. And you was healing that pain within. You see how this all just came out together like that? Ooh, spirit is messy today, honey. Spirit is getting us together today. But you got to let that deep down ugly truth go. Like, we always say wrong truth, yeah. But it's something we saying that's like still make us look a little more worthy in our heads. But you're not completely worthy until you can let all your adversities, good and bad, in the face. Now, I ain't saying you're worthless. I'm just saying you done leveled up on the level that a lot of people is not going to be able to understand your energy. They're not going to be able to understand what's coming out your pores. And you know what? This can come with a lot of jealousy. This can cause a lot of jealousy, a lot of hate. Because things is about to start happening to you. People are not going to understand because of all of the names you were called, who you probably was back in the day. People are starting to see you and be like, oh no. How did this bitch manage to have this life? Just like this, ho. Tell us about surrender, spirit and ancestors, for my Cancer Leo cups. Why is this just surrender energy here for my Cancer Leo cups? Tell me about this surrender energy for my Cancer Leo cups, spirit and ancestors. I'm going to put it in. I love this deck, baby. This is a detail ass. The sun is at the end of this surrender here, baby. Come on. Come on, spirit, and tell us the story. Tell us about this surrender energy for Cancer Leo cups. What do my Cancer Leo cups need to surrender to? Man, shit just flew everywhere, and I ain't gonna even hold you up. This is the five of inspiration. So is that like, that's the five of wands. Ooh, is it? We gonna see. Look at this. Five of wands. What is inspiration? No, five of swords. Ooh. Four of voices. Spirit, what the hell is a voices? Who is the voices? Oh, I gotta look this up, y'all. Yeah, I know I just be figuring these decks out with y'all. I don't even been looked at these decks for real. I just been open them up and shit. Ooh, the priestess is here, baby. Oh, bitch. Okay, here go the priestess out here. Sorry, not sorry. See you, don't see you. Oh, she look like the game player too, bitch. Five of emotions in reverse. So emotions is us. I can get that vibe right. Materials is pentacles. Inspiration and voices. I want to say voices is swords. And inspiration is, fire, because you know that's creativity, and the voices is like in your head, constant voices in your head. Give me some more energy for this worthiness. I mean, surrender for my Cancer Leo cups. What else you have? The chariot, you was out here talking your shit. Yeah, oh, it keep giving us two for the last one. It's supposed to be seven, but whatever. We got a tower here and nine of emotions. Baby, what went on here with this surrender? It's like you was gifted the ultimate gift. Okay, where's the, what's the name at? I'm going to look up inspirations in this book because of how I look. Don't let me down. Don't let me down. Let me down. Five of inspirations. It's time to make the music. I mean, face the music. I'm no longer your muse. So in another life. Okay, say, I don't want to read this. The muse looks down at the rivalry below, the pushing and the pulling. Okay, I can see this. This you in your head going back and forth, losing your fucking mind. He left me not. Should I jump? Should I not jump? Am I all right with this? Am I going to get over this? Am I going to let this go? Am I going to deal with my emotions? Just, you know, y'all know, we be going through that shit in our fucking head. I get it. Trust me, I do. That's why I put a little water there, because half of that water is us crying with our punk asses up here fucking crying and shit because we can't get our life together. Four swords. Why can't you get a four of swords right off bat? The resting. Oh, you need to rest that part of your mind. Look at it. Look how she resting and chilling. Release all that shit from your mind. Go get a spa. Look at him trying to creep in. Who the fuck? Bro, what is that? Trying to keep in your mind. Maybe this is an ancestor trying to watch over you while you release all of this. Make sure no Lord dignities jump on you while you taking this spiritual bath. Look at this in reverse. This, oh my God, this is so fucking beautiful, baby. This is just beautiful. This is just straight free in your damn mind. I just felt free looking at that card, okay? You are more into it. You are highly, you are astronomically intuitive. Y'all know what the fuck I'm trying to say. This is the priestess, not a high priestess. She's just the priestess. She's a bad motherfucker. She see what don't nobody else see. And you know how you think somebody can't see with one eye? That bitch see every goddamn thing with this eye. Do you understand me? This is a sorcerer. This is the magnificent. This is a wizard. A sword. This is Marlon. Five of emotions. Something about you have healed or you have healed. You're letting something go. Something in the past possibly had you hurting. That was that past energy right there. Something had you down and out, worried. Okay. And it looked like you looked within and you found that out about yourself. Like, I gotta let this go. Like, at the end of the day, I have to let something go. And you started working on yourself and you started letting yourself go. But you need to take the time to get out your head. You needed to relax and hear what spirit was trying to say to you. You can't keep getting up going every doggone day in your own head and not relaxing so spirit can talk to you. Okay? Dream on. Dream on. That's what happened. And that's the sign Odu was playing today that caught my eye. I just went dangling back there with him. It was so funny how I attracted to him. It was so weird. Then it was time to go. He needed some documents signed. It came straight to me. And I'm like, why do you think I would do something like that? Like, everybody wondered why I won't take a high-level position because I know everything, but what the fuck do I look like? Okay, no, I'm about to stay right here, mind my business. I got my high level of position with y'all. I put forth the effort and spirit helped me. That's all I got to say. The chariot that came out. You got your head on right. You focused. You determined. You ambitious. Look that same stomach. Look what's glowing out of that motherfucking stomach now. You see? You had to do that last bit of healing. And look what's glowing out of your fucking stomach. You connected through the belly of spirit. That's why your stomach was fucking hurting. Or whoever this was, stomach, or my stomach. I don't know. Somebody's stomach was hurting. Oh, bitch. She's a bad bitch. Y'all some bad bitches. Look at all them horses running behind her, following her, like carrying her. Bitch, she's a motherfucking real stallion. And look at this tower. Look at this tower. Spirit brought this tower so you can see. So you can see who you was. So you can feel who the fuck you was. He needed you to feel. Sometimes people need you to feel some hurt so you can understand the love. Especially somebody that's hard-headed. Somebody who want to sit around here in this motherfucking energy. You're like, girl, if you don't get your ass together. The spirit is the truth. You had to surrender yourself to spirit. You had to surrender so you could see the power of the Most High. You had to surrender. You had to stop with your own way and let them guide you. Look how this connection has came into each other. Just by you taking a rest. Just by you taking that spiritual bath. Just by you wearing that crystal. Just that extra step into what you was holding on to from your past life. It could be a real past life. I'm not saying they fake, but it could be one in this lifetime or one in a previous lifetime. Something that previously has happened that you finally had let go and gave over to God and walked. And look how she walks with her head up high now with this worthiness. Like, no weapon formed against you. You know what I'm saying? You're not worried about what nobody have to say, try to hold over your head or attack you. You can stand in all of it now. Ooh, and that's a different kind of power. Look at her like, hold on, stop yourself. You ain't even telling the story right, bitch. Because at the end of the doggone day, I really believe whatever happened, it was a secret being held. You don't even realize how much you're holding someone else's secret because of what they did to you.
Ooh, spirit, come on out and tell the truth.
Whatever you said could possibly damage somebody else way. You've been carrying the hurt and the pain of what someone inflicted on you. And now you're releasing it. And you're standing in your worthiness, you know, your growth, your experience with this situation. And you're ready to unleash. Ooh. 90 emotions. It freed you to a point of you are fulfilled. And you are happier than ever. And this is where that ego come in at. We was talking about the other day. You're going to have an ego about yourself. People is going to be like, who fuck this bitch and she is? Like, you about to find out who the fuck I am. Try me. Okay? Look at me starting stuff with spirit. But spirit did this. He put that rage in you. Somebody probably came at you. Like, hold on. And you had to stand within yourself. Look. Didn't I tell you set fire to the rain? Bitch. Where's it at? Bitch, you can set fire to the rain. Listen here, okay? You set fire to the rain. On both ends, even on the Nine of Cups. You did not let this get to you. You did not let this hinder you. You did not let this destroy you. You didn't turn out strung out on fucking drugs. And no dig at the people that did, but I don't care if you did or not. You came out of that shit, you crackhead. And then what Judge Master said, you fucking crackhead. Let's own your shit. It's time to own your shit. You was a fucking pill popping cokehead bitch, okay? You was tricking. Or some niggas that took the motherfucking pussy and you was holding a secret all this motherfucking time. But not no more. You're not about to let that shit hinder you no more. Because you fine. Okay, you surrendered to all of that shit that was trying to hold you down. And now you happy. You happy. You at peace. Look at her over there. She is at peace. You in tune right through that motherfucking belly, bitch. Ooh, spirit, you was sending it through my belly all this time. Spirit sent it through my belly, bitch. Like, no matter this tower, the 90 emotions that came out and said what it had to motherfucking say. You is fulfilled spiritually. Emotionally, whatever, you got it all within you. You are highly protected. You're balanced. Your level. You can get other people looking at you like, what in the entire goddamn? Scorpio right here, Chariot here, your ass here, Pisces, and you again here. Who else out here trying to talk shit? The sun, that Leo energy out here. Look at you, bitch. You on fire. You was on fucking fire. This girl is on fire. Bitch, you on fire. This is a beautiful ass mother. This reading, I don't even know. Excuse me. This shit, you have arisen. I'm going to tell you something else. This is going to be dictated according to how you treat this retrograde. Because even for the people who don't believe it, because I had this guy come back to me and tell me, like, you was right. Whatever you did, whatever spell you put on me, you right. I'm like, oh, that don't right. Read it. All you had to do is read what I told you it was. Even when I told the bull about a karmic cycle, read it. Then maybe you can help yourself get out of it. Spirit, tell us about this Arethic cord for my Castileo cup. The Arethic cord. I'm saying umbilical. Don't come for me. Don't come for me. The umbilical cord. Mama ain't playing. Look at her. She got a sword in one motherfucking hand, her son in one hand, her daughter standing next to her ready to take off. You ain't gonna even expect her little ass. And look at Jack-Jack. Look at Jack-Jack from The Incredibles. You're not about to expect when you hold him. You gonna be like, oh, little baby. Next thing you know, he done fucked you up. Y'all know Jack-Jack. Fuck that doggone day, babysitter up. You know, I'm about to watch this shit. This nigga tell the whole fucking house that Jack-Jack wasn't no hoe. Spirit, tell us about this umbilical cord, this Arethian cord, whatever, you know what I mean. The world of cosmos. Ooh, what is this about with the moon? Ooh, baby, what is this about? Spirit, tell us about this umbilical cord for Cancer, Leo, Cusp, Spirit, and Ancestors. We got the Hierophant in reverse. Ooh, messy. I ain't just spread like this since I started reading tarot. But this is interesting. See, Spirit be having their own plans. Six of Inspiration, Six of Swords. I'll be moving. I'm not gonna say this Eight of Voices, but it looked like a commitment wasn't had. A commitment has been broken. And somebody's headed towards something that's more worthy or valuable to them. Or just peace of mind. I don't fucking know. Tell me about this umbilical cord, Spirit and Ancestors. Seven of Inspirations. That's Seven of Wands. Hey, Google. Play. Fucking, I'm about to just let my son bang the fucking house out because he banging over my music anyway. Seven of Inspiration. Oh shit, I done snapped all out. So I think about other shit, y'all. Tell me more about this umbilical cord, Spirit and Ancestors. What is going on with me, child? And I didn't even flip this damn deck over. The Queen of Materials in reverse, baby. And then we got the Eight of Inspirations is out here. We got the Star, baby. And we had the Devil. What the fuck just happened here? It's somebody. It's somebody. This somebody else. You know, well, listen, it's about to get real. Spirit just got this shit real as hell. Because then I say it's the end of something. Something has ended. Something has been torn down, broken. A relationship is over. Somebody's spirituality has been broken. They don't trust who they used to trust. The religion they used to trust is gone now. They don't believe that shit no more. Somebody's going through some shit right here. And they trying to go find out where it's at. Somebody's trying to find their new tribe. They're ending something. Somebody's ending their relationship. They on a boat towards their new tribe. Or their new found inspiration. And this Seven of Swords is like they're giving themselves back to the ethers to help guide them in a better direction. They're trying to protect themselves. They might have to turn back around and protect themselves against something. This Queen of Pentacles, I don't know who she is, y'all. Is she you? With a chariot that came out. Ain't no other queen out here. It could be any, but I don't, this not you. This is somebody who's healing from an ending. I mean, you could have been in a relationship and it end, or a marriage. This probably was a marriage that has ended. this Queen of Pentacles is broke. She don't, the Eight of Inspiration. See, she's coming in to make communication. This can be male energy. They can be in a Queen of Pentacles energy. They're not taking care of their kids. They're on a money hunt. That's what this Queen of Pentacles is on. She gonna look the part, but she ain't got the pockets to look the part that she look. They coming in with a message. They coming in with something to say. They coming in with high hopes with this Star card, okay? High hopes. This is like a big wish of theirs. But see, this devil in this world of cosmos lets me know right then and there. This is some trickery here. They coming in to start a new toxic cycle with you. That's what they want. They coming in to look how this devil is playing a game. Coming in to play another motherfucking game and connect you to another fucking cycle. I think somebody's going to be rudely awakened and find out that this cycle is over. I don't believe, and I don't feel like you about to accept this back in. These high hopes this person got, that's just what they going to have. It's high hopes. And look how she making this little sad ass face. That's that high hope. That's that manipulation. Coming in, trying to act like they want you to sympathize with them. That too long they've been your puppet master. And a part of me think some of y'all little toxic asses is about to play with them. Y'all like, okay, come outside. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Let's go out to eat. Run the bill up, go to the bathroom, and deuces, bitch. Have a whole nother nigga pick you up. I was treacherous in my day. That's that Queen of Cups in reverse on your ass, bitch. You meant to get, and that Queen of Wands in reverse, bitch. You got me fucked up. That's how fucked up you got me. Even know what that is. Yeah, something went down. Somebody is about to end a relationship, end a commitment, end a situation. Somebody is getting out of something. They're thinking about what they're going to do. They're thinking about their move. Look how she's upset. You see how she's sitting up there off thinking into oblivion. Look, this is a couple, okay? Or God and dominion, but look, this little motherfucker don't give a fuck no more. It's like they're out of here. They looking for something else. They could be looking back at something, but no, they're not looking back at something. This is somebody moving forward, Six of Swords. They're looking the opposite direction. They're over this. They called out their bounty hunters. It's like somebody had a wake-up call about something. Be careful, because the toxic part of all of this is like this sun. What is love? Do this person know what love is? Six of seven of inspirations. Defending your position, being attacked, protecting your inner light. Oh, this you protecting your inner light possibly against this person coming into you. This person is about to come into you, like I said, with all this communication. It's about to be a Queen of Pentacles coming into you in reverse. That's what you need to cut the cord to. You need to cut the cord with this bitch. This is it for this hoe. With this puppy doll ass face shit. Yeah, you need to cut the motherfucking cord with them. This could be your addiction. You all can equally be each other's addiction. That's no good for each other. The only way you're going to head off into the cosmos, this new cycle in life, this is like your final chapter. This is going to be the final test. And because remember, it was a last battle. Remember that one? I ain't going to never forget that one. That was personal. I think it's a month or so ago. That last battle, that last stand against your fucking devil. And here it go. And now spirit is finally telling us from what we done worked on and how far we done came, it's time for you to face this once and for all and see if you can handle it. Would you be able to stand up to it? Are you about to fall weak? Oh my God. Somebody is probably going to come in and give you everything you hope and wish for. But it's going to wind up being at a cost. It's going to be a cost. They still the same fuck ass. That's who they are. They're coming to keep you back on the cycle. I'm trying to tell you, somebody's trying to get you back on the same cycle. But this is what they're not going to understand. I feel like you're going to enter into your new cycle. I don't think you're going to accept them back, because this is your future card for this cutting the cord, this umbilical cord, this attachment. You finally going to cut the cord. Ooh, spirit showed out today, didn't she? Spirit been showing out here lately, y'all. Don't play with me. This bitch a hoe. Okay, let me see. I'm gonna put this with that. Nah, I'll put this. This gonna show more. Oh, this is a beautiful deck. I love it. Don't get shocked when y'all see it. Cause I finally, you know how many times I done looked at this deck and never ever bought it, had it in my hand, took it to the register, never bought it. But something just made me buy this deck. I seen it. Well, I thought it was this deck, and it wasn't even this deck. It was a totally different other deck that I had seen. But this was the one when I got it. I'm like, fuck it, it's time for me to have you. And it really was time for me to have you. Hey, Spirit. I said, hey, Spirit, y'all. Hey, Google. Next. Yes, I'm telling y'all. Look how the deck cut. Look how it cut. Look how these swords is here. Like, you not about to accept this at all. You got your mental is balanced. You got your motherfucking cup balanced. Your emotions is fucking balanced. Look, somebody is about to worship your motherfucking ass. Somebody possibly got money and change, and now they broke it. Here they back. Look, y'all hear Keisha? You got dough and change, bitch. You had, and then you went off and protected yourself. They probably had you in conflict. They probably had you in your, look, they had you in your head. They had you in contact. They had you going through all types of shit. That truth came in and saved you. They probably was talking about you, letting people talk about you. This Knight of Swords, somebody was up here talking about you, and they ain't say nothing. You trusted somebody. They was disloyal. They betrayed you. They ran off with the ops. So go on and face your karma, because at the end of the day, there's going to be treacherous when they come to your door and they find out it ain't nothing there. You are protecting your motherfucking space by any means necessary. This bitch is bucking naked. And when she come up off that motherfucking ground, it's gonna prism or whatever she is, diamond. It's gonna be a exorcism to some motherfuckers. Cause ain't no, I told you, didn't I tell you, you the energy you exude, now people not gonna understand that shit. They're not gonna understand who the fuck you are now. The glow that's coming off of you, they gonna feel like you're unworthy of it. You do not deserve it. This is actually a time when you need to just, you know how the rappers, it's time for them to move. It's time to move. But this person is coming head in. I don't know why the Queen of Pentacles choose to come in. If I don't feel like she's you. If it's you, you done chose to. Because if it's you, you could be defending your position as far as either you have some type of toxic spiritual belief and you defending it. I can't see this being you. I mean, I ain't saying you can't be toxic now. Because both of these stories is vice versa. Hell, this would be somebody's damn mama for all I know. Just toxic hell for parents is toxic. Kids is toxic. You can have a toxic cat. But somebody coming in hot, baby. They coming in hot with hopes that this is going to be forever. It's obsessed possessiveness. Control, whatever. They probably had drunk, feet stank, feet dirty. I don't know. They gonna probably need a bath. They gonna be wounded. don't know what the fuck going on. I don't know. Spirit, what's going on? Okay, what's the conclusion to this reading for my Cancer Leo cup? And one day here, see, you told this motherfucker you're not going to be here. Look how that came out. You told him you're not going to be here. Now they got unacquired love with you because you told their ass you was good. And this is their unacquired love ass fought, okay? The Wheel of Fortune in reverse. That is your victory. Look how she's sitting up on that motherfucking chariot looking fine as hell, bitch. This is what you get. This person is going to grovel at your motherfucking knees. They're going to beg for freaking forgiveness because of their betrayal. Only think about it. This person is willed by money. Queen of Swords in reverse right here. Somebody is Seven of Wands. Wait a minute, what happened? They got Moses out here, the Princess of Wands. Oh, wow. And the Empress in reverse with the King of Pentacles in reverse. What happened here, sugar? Who is these people? Somebody is having a battle with their mama and their baby mama look like. That's what it look like. It's a fight going on with the mama and the baby mama. And the baby mama standing her ground, bitch. She don't give a fuck, okay? Ooh, that was messy. But anyway, this is the love that's not going to... They really believe that they got a chance and they about to find out the hard way that they don't. You are gone and never coming back. And this is their fucking karma. This is not your karma. This is their karma. I'm going to say it's not yours or theirs. I'm going to say it was whoever was at fault here. We're going to do that, okay? This Six of Wands is whoever's at fault here. Okay? Because somebody most definitely got a victory on their hands. Somebody is being seen. This is probably their fault for being a hoe. Trying to run around and be seen and be around everybody. Because, you know, if you leveling up, ain't your spouse supposed to... Look what fell out on the floor in reverse. Being a hoe and being around everybody. Didn't I just say that? That's what this Six of Wands is about. Somebody out here trying to get all the attention from anybody they can get attention from. Don't try to hold your head up high after I play you, but try to make it seem like I didn't play you. Look, bitch, you put your boundaries up to this motherfucker. Look, they trying to come to you like they don't know what's up. Like they don't know this not like you don't know what's up. Like you don't know that this is their fucking karma. They trying to come in to you and just knock that shit out the motherfucking frame. Look at you like hold on. Look, the house burning down around you and everything. You don't give a fuck. Like they trying to tear up everything you got going on. And look what's up here. The motherfucking star. Bitch, you is protected. You're not worried about shit. Everything burning down. Everything is burning down. You did not bend a fucking break. Come on, Spirit. You did not bend a fucking break. Tell some people to be careful just in case a motherfucker do try to burn your house up. Somebody could have got caught doing that. Jealousy would make somebody do that, y'all. Tell me more to this conclusion, Spirit and Ancestors, for my Cancer Leo Cups. Nine of Cups. Why is the Nine of Cups is here after a house getting burned down, after somebody standing up to a damn thirsty ass whore? Two of Cups. What the fuck is going on, Spirit? Because you want to know what happened? That shit possibly turned somebody on. You out here like that. Somebody going to come to your motherfucking aid. That's what's going to happen. Shit, this person got everything they need. You got everything you need. That's why somebody's trying to come in and have this victory with you. It really looked like somebody's trying to make it seem like to you that they cool, they happy, they content, they got everything going on. But in all actuality, They don't got shit going on. Somebody is trying to align with you. They trying to put you through some type of fire or through some type of storm to bring you back down off your pedestal so you can align with them. Oh, this a dirty little hoe. Because they see fulfillment with you. They see a family with you, possibly. They see Two of Cups. They see a Two of Cups with you. Because they possibly could have just lost it somewhere the fuck else, honestly. They probably coming in to you because they lost it with somebody else because of how they treated you. And they're realizing that shit now. But what they not realizing is you about to protect your space at all costs, bitch. It took you too long to realize that. That's why this fucking Prince of Pentacles is right here at this bottom of the deck. You took too fucking long, okay? And now they're not here for a genuine reason. Now they're here because of something that happened. And don't nobody want nobody back after something that went wrong somewhere else. Bitch, you fucking bitch. Don't come on to me with everything fucked up in your world. That cord is cut. And this could also be you being fulfilled and content with yourself that you do wind up finding somebody else. And they can't take it. Somebody can't fucking take it. There's somebody Six of Wands riding by looking at you like they got it all together and shit. And they sitting up here bawling. They done lost it with all they other bitches. They ain't got no other bitches. They will ain't spinning. They ain't manifesting. They ain't got shit going on in their damn life. Nine Pentacles in reverse. They sitting up here trying to act like they got a girl. They got it going on, but they broke and destitute and a piece of shit. Don't you just hate it, Prince of Wands? Look, trying to come in like he the finest man in town, though. This nigga trying to look like he the finest. Anyway, y'all, peace and love.